Here is a look at your forecast now on your Thursday at 4:47 as we take a live look outside, some beautiful blue skies.
I think we need to bottle this weather up and just keep it the entire spring into the summer.
Yeah, because once that summer comes, Devon, man, we'd be wishing for this weather to come back.
I am with you all. I was just chatting with Brandon behind the scenes here, our producer, and saying that this is probably the best spring we've had in several years. I don't know if you agree with that. It seems like a couple of years ago, we were kind of cloudy and kind of humid all spring. And then last year, we jumped right into summer. This year, we've had some fine days like this. Island View Casino Cam also looking great with blue skies. I want to get into our hurricane forecast we've issued today and also from Dr. Phil Klotzbach of Colorado State University. Last year, we were under an El Nino. This is warmer water temperatures off of South America. What it does is creates high pressure, and that gives a better chance for development in the Pacific, but that puts the subtropical jet stream rolling through the Gulf and into the Caribbean, where that creates wind shear. Kept the development of systems down last year, but we still had an active season. But this year, it's a 60% chance the water temperature is dropping below average. What that does is lessen that subtropical jet stream, and that creates more high pressure, a chance for more development in the Caribbean, in the Atlantic. And the Atlantic water temperatures have been running ridiculously record warm so far this season, the warmest we've ever had on record. The combination of those two factors are the biggest driver for this forecast right now, which we have an extremely active season compared to average. If we get above 21 named storms, we have to go to the supplemental list. Maybe 10 hurricanes would be right in the middle and several major hurricanes. This doesn't necessarily mean we would have activity here to make landfall, but it shows that it could be an active season. Again, we would keep you up to date on this. Dr. Phil Klotzbach, Colorado State University. This is the greatest, most active hurricane forecast he's ever issued in April. This would surpass the named list going to the supplemental list. 11 hurricanes and 5 major. That is indicating an extremely active, or as I'm calling it, a hyperactive season. The best thing to do is get ready early, have your plans in place. We'll have our hurricane special coming up in May. Now, we just want to look at last year, where we had almost an average season being forecast was upped later in the year by the National Hurricane Center, and they'll have their forecast next month. Right now, we're looking at 70s across the region under beautiful blue skies. The breeze picked up a little bit again today as anticipated. But we still continue beautiful spring days to finish the week on Friday. A couple clouds roll in on Saturday, a few more on Sunday. Listen, it's just a temperature forecast and cloud forecast yet again through the weekend. Then Monday's a different story for the eclipse. Clear night, crisp start to Friday morning here in the North Shore's 40s. It's 50s South Shore. High goes to 80. Beautiful blue sky day. I wouldn't be surprised if a high in the sky cloud rolls through. Then we go into Saturday. A few clouds will start to roll in. It's 50s and 50s to around 60 to start off the weekend. Not as crisp. And a couple of clouds, still a decent amount of sun. We're still looking at upper 70s and a great day for us. We look into Saturday during the day, and again, a couple of clouds nowhere there. And into Sunday's forecast, a few more in the afternoon. Still nearing 80 for the high temperature. So the weekend again is great. But look what happens into Monday. We have the approach of this system, more clouds starting to build by Monday morning, becoming even possibly more overcast throughout the day and a chance of some showers. Unfortunately, that still puts a lot of cloud cover into the eclipse forecast on Monday. There's a chance we see some breaks, but right now it's high likelihood it's more overcast and we may not see much. WDSU First Warning Weather 7-day forecast, sunny and 80 tomorrow, 79 a couple of clouds Saturday, near 80 and a few more clouds Sunday. And we'll look at next week's forecast closely.